Hello and thanks for watching Proactive New York. I'm joined by Gijsbert Groenewegen, the CEO, also Bruce Bragagnolo, the Executive Chairman of Regency Silver Corporation. Bruce, good to meet you both.
Good morning.
So gents, for those viewers not familiar with the company, tell us more about Regency Silver. Bruce, I'll start with you.
Thanks, Stephen. Regency Silver is a Mexican-focused silver explorer. And our flagship property is the Dios Padre property in northern Sonora, Mexico, a place that I'm very familiar with, having been the CEO of Timmins Gold in the past and operating the San Francisco mine, which is also north of Hermosillo. So the property that we're currently drilling, the Dios Padre property, has been in the company for 4 years, and we finally are able to get the drills turning, and we're halfway through our current drill program at Dios Padre. So we're very excited to see the results from the program. We're drilling into a very large induced polarization anomaly, and it looks like we're hitting our target. We're also drilling over at the existing Dios Padre mine, and it looks like we're hitting our target there as well. So overall, we're very encouraged by what we see so far, and it's all subject to assays, of course, because the assays will tell us what the concentration of mineral is in the core. So far, so good. The drills are turning well. And things are going well on the ground. So we'll keep our fingers crossed for the assay results, which should be coming out sometime over the next, we'll be getting a steady stream of assay results over the next 6 weeks. So we'll see how that all goes.
Mm. And of course, Mexico is the hot destination for silver at the moment, the biggest producer. Gijs, take us through how you see the fundamentals for silver at this stage, particularly as we enter this very tough macroeconomic environment.
Yep. once you know that basically precious metals are driven by negative real interest rates, i.e. that inflation is higher than the interest rates, or by geopolitical factors. So it's a little bit of a myth to say that, you know, if there's inflation, that that precious metals have to go up. That's not the case, because if they are getting compensated by higher interest rates, you don't lose any purchasing power. But that's not the case at the moment. We know that in Europe, where the inflation is 8.9% and the key interest rates is 0%, that means basically that your negative real interest rates in Europe are -8.9%. In the USA, we just saw that Powell increased the Fed funds rate from 2.5%, and there the negative real interest rates are -6.7%, because the inflation in the US is 9.1%. And I expect the inflation to continue to go higher. Why? Because we have, as we know, a labor shortage, and that's purely the case because the companies are not willing to pay up yet. But that's slightly happening. And we also see the two main factors that drive next to wages, the inflation, are energy and food. And we have, again, a huge number of ships waiting on the West Coast of the U.S. to be unloaded. It's back to 153 ships. And we also see that, you know, the Gazprom has basically halved, you know, its supply through Nord Stream 1 of net gas to about 20%. So what we will see is that net gas, which is used in order to make ammonia and which is being used to make fertilizer and as such food, are going to be strongly reduced because of the, you know, shortage in supply of net gas in Europe. So I think the overall outlook for gold and silver is very, very good. You see, should see it as a hedge for your portfolio. If you still believe, you know, everything looks honky-dory, at least take a hedge out in terms of gold and silver. And then the last bit I would like to mention is that the silver and silver companies are even better investments than purely investing in physical gold and silver. Why? Because they have a beta of 3. which means that if the silver price rises by 10%, the prices of the silver mining companies rise by 30%, which gives you an enormous good return, especially when the assays of a company are very promising.
Yeah, apart from the hedge benefits, Gijs, what do you see as the demand drivers for silver? Because I know that it is used in electric vehicles and a whole other number of other applications.
Correct. And what we have seen is that the three factors basically that at the moment driving that, that's the investment demand, which was very high in 2021. We see it in solar panels, but by far also, you know, the very promising on the long term are the electrical vehicles. I mean, I think the penetration of electrical vehicles at the moment is only 3 to 5%. Yeah, but by 2025, 2030, we should go up to more than 50%, which should have a huge impact on the demand for silver.
Bruce, maybe coming back to you just before we wind up. I mean, you took us through the Dios Padre mine halfway through the drill program. Tell us what sort of news flow investors should be looking out for from the company.
I can't tell you how great it is to get back on the ground again after 2 years of being stuck at home. It's just so nice to get in a pickup truck and kick some rocks and look at new projects. So the first thing is we are assessing very promising new projects, and that's part of my next trip to Mexico, as well as reviewing the drill program. But we have been actively looking at some very promising new projects. We also assessed our current projects. For example, at El Tule, which is in Nayarit, there's artisanal miners working the ground all over the place. And they wouldn't be working that ground if they weren't getting at least a half an ounce of gold out of the ground. So that's very promising to see all those people who are basically prospecting for us. So that's one of the focuses. Is our second project is El Tule, but it's also great to be up at Dios Padre back in Sonora, my old stomping grounds. Just looking at projects there, the Dios Padre project is an existing 10 million ounce resource. We're hoping to add to that. There's other projects available in the area, so it's just nice to get active again. And reconnect with the old crew at Timmins Gold and assess properties and just get that infrastructure happening again. Get active, add value through acquisition, through drilling. And one of the biggest assets that we have is our connections in Mexico, the ability to get things done, the knowledge on the ground, the ability to get to properties, the ability to know who to talk to when you need to get something accomplished. So it's just nice to reconnect with everybody.
Well, gents, I hope you'll keep us updated on any new developments at the company. And thank you very much for the introduction today.
Thank you, Stephen.
Thank you, Stephen.
Gijsbert Groenewegen is the CEO, Bruce Bragagnolo, the executive chairman of Regency Silver Corp.